Hi, we're Team Rock-It.
That's Rock-It.
We're going to be setting some records and raising some money for charity. This is happening.
This is happening.
Stephen, say this is happening.
No, because you know I don't want to be here.
Why? What's wrong with this?
Look, I don't like filming and I don't like breaking records. If it was up to me, we would be sitting in my flat right now watching the Jonas Brothers in 3D.
Stephen, you've already seen all the episodes of the Jonas Brothers. What does it matter?
I know I have, but I really like re-watching them.
What ones are on? Is there a really good one?
I think it's that one where, you know, when Kevin gets his like shirt stuck in the toaster and like Joe and Nick try to help him, but like...
Oh, I love Joe.
That is a good episode. Yeah.
Right, Stephen, you're ruining the take.
Look, okay. I don't care. I'm going to go watch the Jonas Brothers.
Stephen.
Nick is so dreamy.
Wow, it looks like it's me and you breaking some records.
I don't know. I actually really like the Jonas Brothers.
All right. So, I mean, I was going to let you do it like that and everything, but you just...
I would like to just hang about my boxers all day, but I've got things to do, so...
Oh,
Jonas, a clock.
Come on, mate. Come on, I had a schedule of fun plan for this. This was going to be great.
This is happening. Jonas Brothers are happening.
The fundraising. Aye, that's right, they got an Ed to do the voiceover. It is a Scottish documentary after all.
All of the money that we're going to make doing these records is going to be donated to Bernardo's. That's right, Bernardo's.
Chris started rounding up sponsors by telling them about Team Rocket's plans to attempt Scottish record setting in order to aid Bernardo's. Bernardo's have been around since 1876. During all this time, they have helped children under any circumstances, whether they've been abused, neglected, or abandoned. Bernardo's have taught us that every child deserves a good start in life, and our fundraising was going to help them achieve just that. Record 1. It's the highest open-air game of Hungry Hippos ever played.
For our first record, we're going to play the highest ever open-air game of Hungry Hippos, and to do that, we're going to climb a mountain. We're going to have a whale of a time just like this hippo, aren't we, Matty?
What?
We're going to have a whale of a time just like this hippo.
Yeah.
No, we're not.
Yes, we are.
Seriously.
Look at how happy this is on the box. That's going to be us at the top of the mountain. Hey, you're going to lose all the pieces. They're impossible to find.
What is the point? Who would want to do this?
I would.
Who does this?
Yeah, but he's having the time of his life.
I'm a bear.
We're going to have a whale.
I'm a bear.
5 minutes.
Right? You need to shut your mouth, all right?
And then,
Stephen,
and then I did
you're
the
ruining toilet. The take.
No,
you always ruin
that's it.
I built this hut.
Kids. This is what I think. Look at your hut. Look at I destroyed it. I destroyed your hut.
I like to destroy stuff. Can we climb some hills, please?
Yeah, we can climb some hills.
This is my hill climbing stick.
I love
stick.
Climbing hills. I got up so early lava. Today to climb this hill. I love it.
I fucking hate it.
Thank the Lord, I'm up so early on a Saturday to climb this hill.
Aye, the crew began their long journey to the Mithertap Peak of Bennachie, a grand 1,699 feet. They went to play the highest ever game of Hungry Hungry Hippos, and they'll be setting the currently unrecorded world record. Triple H, as it's known to us guys, is a Hasbro game. It's been around since 1978 and that still gets played today.
Well, we've made it up to the top of the hill, so now it's time to get the highest ever game of Hungry Hippos ever played.
Wanna win the game, you gotta take a good aim and get your most marbles with your hippos. Playing Hungry Hungry Hippos. Hungry Hungry Hippos. Hungry Hungry Hippos is the name of the game, and whoever's hippo eats the most marbles wins. Hungry Hungry Hippos. Yeah, I'm playing Hungry Hungry Hippos. Hungry Hungry Hippos from Hasbro. Oh, alright mate, what's for lunch? It's Hungry Hungry Hippos! Hungry Hungry Hippos! Hungry Hungry Hippos! We're Hungry Hungry Hippos, whichever hippo gobbles up the most marbles wins! Adult assembly required. Oh yeah, battery's not included. Record 2. The fastest time an obese person, or fat prick, has ever ran down Union Street, Aberdeen.
Union Street. A good street, a brilliant street. An amazing street. But one thing, how fast can an obese person run down it? It's time to find out.
Well, I've not done much training for this. About 15 and a half stone, so look, pretty sexy. People whistling at me over there. So Yeah, I think if I just imagine a big monster running after me, I think I could run quite fast.
That's Chris off on his 0.8 mile dash. Look at him run, his flab and members of public getting in the way. There's no current record of an obese person running down Union Street, but he better bloody set a goodie.
Hi there, I'm going to tell you some facts about Union Street, and to make it a little bit more interesting, I'm dressed as Wolverine. Basically, Union Street was built along King Street in the 9th century. When Union Street was built, it nearly bankrupted Aberdeen, but fortunately it didn't. And now it provides... Hey! Try to do work here, mate.
Six minutes, 51. That's really slow. So exhausting. So many people getting in the way. Yeah. I don't think any obese person's ran faster than that down Union Street.
I see.
Yeah. Oh, my heart is pounding.